Seneca Hampton. Aye. Where you at, boss?
I'm in the booth with Pirates.
Hey. They don't got me back in here. Hey.
Why every time I pop, I sing like the same little click, they get on the rat. No, they bumping Usher, all this hating, yeah, they got it bad. Slick shots ain't stopping no motion, they going outside. Ain't even popped it yet, better scratch they ass and go get glass. Straight to the bag, take off, no Migos, used to be just me. Now I'm Pat Riley, Jasu and Bingo, the big three. Every day a battle, feel like it's 300 against me.
And bringing our own Lit 100 top players in Mississippi. Can we get a hand clap, everybody? Can we get a hand clap, everybody? What you got going, Bingo?
Man, I've been hearing about this list for I don't know how long. All the hard work you say you've been putting into it, man. I'm ready for you to get it out there so we can see all this hard work you've been putting into it.
They just don't know, bro. Like, when we say we scout the state, fam, we really scout the state of Mississippi. I'm talking about down to a T. It gives you so much anxiety because you don't want to leave nobody out, put nobody on, this, that. And the main thing I always hear with all these lists and stuff like that is, it's politics. Well, look, I ain't running for president, mayor, or nothing. I'm just going to let you know that now from the jump. So he ain't got to endorse me or nothing because ain't nothing political about this. This is strictly off of, man. I wanted to make sure we did a list strictly off of. Not only already being, you know, ranked, already, you know, saying having great film, but also the longevity, how long you've been doing it. It's some of these guys on the list that's been doing this since they was freshmen. And it's some guys on the list that are freshmen that just became sophomores and they just went off. And we just know that they're going to be incredibly top-ranked guys in the nation. So, without further ado, let's get to it. Number 100.
Jack Richardson, out of Madison Central, class of 25, punter, 6'2", 210 pounds, is your first 100th ranked player from the top lit 100 of MSA. Elaborate. Why Mr. Jack gets to be the first one to kick it off.
Man, people like, man, why you put a punt on there? First of all, when I got to looking at the top players that's already ranked in the state of Mississippi as far as like on 24/7, I looked and I saw that we got a three-star punter. So I'm like, why is this guy ranked so high as a punter from Mississippi? Because that is very rare to me. This is a three-star punter, so maybe go dig into his film. Man, this guy is freaking 6'3", 205, first of all. He had 25 punts with a 46.3-yard net average. The man had a 56% of his punts inside of the 20. This is in high school now. The man had 5-for-8 field goals, one game winner. He went 22 for 22 on all PATs. 46 kickoffs, bro. Get this. 37 of his kickoffs were touchbacks. One onside, two pooches. 86% on attempting touchbacks. The man goes crazy. His hang time was 3.9 hang time. Like the man, like I said, so when you look at this man film, you can honestly see this man got a boot that's already ready for the NFL right now. And we got this right inside of Mississippi, bro. Like, what you feel about this pick? Did I hit or miss on this 100 right here, man, with this partner,
man? Man, hey, I'm looking at the film. The film don't lie, you know, and he's pinning defenders back, you know. So, and if they put a punter back there, the punter's supposed to be that dog. He can get he's supposed to be able to get loose, and he's making it hard for them to be able to create space because that ball got so much hang time. And he's pinning it back there behind the
punt. And every punt, he's changing the field. Like every punt, he's changing the field. This ain't like one punt or two. Like every punt that he got on this film, He is setting the defense up to be able to play with the offense back against their own end zone. And that's big time, bro, especially in high school football. Being a high school coach, my own self, you don't just see punters that can just change the field like that in high school, bro. Right.
Nah, I like I get it, man. You got, and plus, man, punters are special, man. They are needed, man. Like you said, they pin the ball back behind the line to get a defense a better chance.
Do you feel me? And that, like I said, man, like I said, big time players make big time plays, man. That's all I can tell you. And our number 100 pick, Jack Richardson from Madison Central. Number 99, 2026 O lineman, 6'3", 315 pounds, Aiden Newell out of Brandon, Mississippi, bro. Roll the footage.
Number 99. Okay, no, you. So this is offensive lineman. You're a big boy, man. So I see what you know. This is what offense. These kids will always make money.
Forever.
6'3". So he's a junior. No, he's a sophomore.
He's a junior.
He'll be 315. Oh, he's gonna be a future Danny Dozen.
Off the muscle.
Yeah,
I saw him last year when I was recruiting for the sophomore game. He didn't play in it, but I remember him from last year. And like I said, his film is crazy, man. I'm talking about when you want to see young, physical, offensive linemen, this is what we look at right here. Finishing your blocks. This is a pass play. He's finishing blocks like that on a pass play. Like that's what you got to have about you when you a lineman. You got to have that dog about you, fall on you and lay on you. That's what you got to have about you. When you use a lineman, if you want next level guys right here, I'm talking about like his first step is going to be great right here. Good positioning. Okay, good. Lay on it again. And this, like I said, this is his sophomore season right here. Like a kid already, that polished as a sophomore, man, just think about what he's going to be these next 2 years. What can he give you these next 2 years? Like, because he's handling everybody. And this is 7-8 football we're talking about. Yeah. What you think about him, big dog?
I'm looking at him, bro. He, tape don't lie. Big kid, you know, you see,
like you see him on the pool right there. Like,
right, come on. Man, he'll be playing possibly SEC football on Saturdays.
Off the muscle. Oh, you know, we definitely will see this kid on Saturdays for sure.
Most definitely. Yeah. All you got to do is just keep a cool head, stay out of the news, headline, and show these other rappers bedtime.
Hell on. I'm talking about, hey, all this mama don't need to get ready to know if this is going to be cash time in just a few years. If the storm is over, if it's been a storm, I promise you.
Oh, yeah, man.
Good,
so,
good grief, man. Look at him pulling right there, bro.
Oh,
well,
yeah.
Kick one.
Boy, yeah, he's sweet on the feet. Oh, yeah, he's sweet on his feet,
oh,
too.
Yeah, he ready, bro. But like I said, once again, number 99, man, from Brandon, Mississippi, 2026, Aiden Newell, man. I'm talking about keep your ears and eyes peeled for this guy, because I promise you will be hearing about him and seeing a lot of him very soon.
Who we got next, man? Who's number 98 on the top lit 100 MSA?
How they do it on the NFL Network? Number 98, 2025 wide receiver, 5'10", 175 pounds, Dylan Graham. Roll the tape. From Philadelphia, Mississippi. D. Philadelphia, Mississippi.
Roll that footage.
Roll that beautiful bean footage. Now, bro, I'm telling you, like, he had a great season last year, man. Like I said, he really shocked me with just the productivity that he did pop out with last year. A lot of big plays with a lot of talent around him last year, but to still be able to get off like he did, it was really great. Like I said, he got a little shiftiness about it. I like to see him in the slot. I like to see him, I'm a little partial because, you know what I'm saying, I coach him, I watch him every day, but I like to see him in the slot. He's good on extended plays, man. He's going to make that extra push when he catch the ball. That's another thing I like about him. Like I said, with him to be added to this list, I just feel like it's off of the year that he had last year with the year that I feel like he's set to have this year. Like, he really splashed on the scene big time last year as a big contributor to Philadelphia High School when they was in a semi-rebuilding stage. But like I said, as you see, man, I ain't got to keep on talking about him. You see, he's making plays, like continuously getting open. So what did you think about him, big dog?
You talk like you know the kid so well. He must be a dog.
Oh, yeah. Hey, man, look, he barf a little bit.
Yeah,
he's coming, he's gonna play a little safety, he's gonna play a little corner, he's all over the field, man. That's why I like him as an athlete, man. He does a lot of things, and like I said, you can rely on him to play a lot of positions for you.
No, I'm talking about he might be a Mississippi dog.
Oh, no, he actually played for Mesh Academy. Okay. Played for Mesh Academy, yep.
You speak very highly of my boy, man. What's up? That's what's up, man.
Yeah, one of the hometown kids that I've been knowing since he's been spit out, and it just feels great to be able to add him on a list like this off of his talent, not just off of knowing him.
Right, right. It ain't even by offers. Nah. It ain't even by, you know, like it's by giving them kids that we believe that should deserve this platform.
Yeah, because some guys, you know what I'm saying, some guys just ain't seen it being in a two-way school.
You know the motto. You know my motto. I always say, man, well, we want to make these kids seen, heard, and noticed. The ones that need it. That's the main thing, man.
Some kids just need that one spotlight put on them to have their name in the conversation with the other ones. And I feel like this is one of those kids for sure. But, man, as I say it again, number 98, Dylan Graham, athlete from Philadelphia, Mississippi. Make sure y'all remember the name and check this kid out throughout the season.
Right.
Only one Magnolia.
We got number 97 up, like, next.
All right. 97.
Number 97.
Number 97. Who would that be? Oh, 2025 linebacker, 6'1", 216, Cam Evans from West Lowndes. And, oh, my goodness, man. When I tell you, I found out about this kid, was just looking at some of the top players in the state already on 24/7, man. And he was already a three-star on there. And I was like, from West Lowndes? Let me cut the tape off. But somebody must know something I don't know. Man, listen. Watch this. That's all I'm going to tell you. That's all I'm going to tell you, fam. Cam Evans is a man. And I think West Lowndes is like a 1A school, bro.
We'll see.
Like, real talk. And he's ranked.
You need to see him on that. Check him out.
I'm talking about athlete.
Check him out now. Big boy that can move now.
Athlete. Good outside linebacker. They got him playing inside, outside, everything. But look, I'm talking about he doesn't play, bro. He doesn't play the Raiders. This is a crazy athlete. We don't find an athlete in 1A that is just, look at how big this kid is, bro. Come on, bro. Like, let's do it. What we got?
He's smelling.
Let's do it. Driving on that near hill.
Hey, he's downhill now. He boy look like he can play that safety.
Man, look like he know what he's doing. Like I said, this is a 1A school. This man is over here terrorizing folks. I love it. I love that sticky nose in there.
I'm already knowing.
Why did I come driving it? Pig. I'm talking about he crazy. This is crazy. This is a 1A player doing this, man. Why ain't nobody talking about this kid? Oh, he'll get over here and run the ball too now. Let's not act like he's not going to get over here and run this ball too. The kid, like I said, I really feel like we don't find a gem in Mississippi that people really need to hear about. Like, for real. Cam Evans from West Lowndes, man, 6'1", 216. Y'all see how athletic this kid is. If you don't have him on your radar now, coaches, it's probably time to put him on there because he's ranked as a three-star on 24/7. And I've never heard this kid until we started doing this list. So somebody need to be speaking louder. I'm just going to be real with you because I ain't never heard of him until we started making this list. And this man is a dog. Make sure, again, if you don't do anything else, remember this kid's name. Cam Evans from West Lowndes, man. Tap in with this kid. He is a steal. Again, number 97, Cam Evans.
How many offers he got in the office?
Let me go look up his stuff again, man. Like I said, I just know that he was on 24/7. I think I saw like 3-4 offers, but he a three-star though, for sure. So y'all make sure y'all tap in with Cam Evans from West Lounge, man. Number 97, top player in the state of Mississippi. Mississippi. Oh, excuse me. MSA one, Lit 100. And we back. Number 96.
Tell me about Camp Lowe. What you know about Camp Lowe from Parkline Academy, a private school?
Cam Lott. He had to correct me on the first time I met him in my All-Star game. He had to correct me on that. It's Cam Lott. Cam Lott from Parkline Academy, man. 6'5", 220 defensive end. Athletic, also plays tight end, man. He's a very athletic kid. I feel like more people need to be on him. I think he's committed to Navy. I think he's committed to Navy. Like I said, the kid is a steal. Like, if nobody ain't been talking about this kid, they need to go ahead and start talking about him. 6'5", 220, edge rusher. That's tough. That's tough out of high school. Oh! I'm talking, he goes crazy out here now. Like, I'm talking about scrapes down the D-line, uses his hands well. Look at him. Athletic kid. Yes, sir. Yeah. Very athletic kid. Like I said, he's doing all this at 6'5". This kid definitely needs to be on a lot of coaches' radars, man. Like I said, I think I already saw him commit to a school. I'm really not sure what school it was again. I know I had saw him commit, though, because I've been following him ever since he was in our All-Star game. He came on the scene. I remember when he was doing one-on-ones in the sophomore game, man. I was just like, boy, you was an athlete. I was like, man, I know you got to go crazy at defensive end, though. Like, you 6'5". What you think about him, bro?
Hey, you know I like them big cornbread fed boys from Mississippi, man. And he's big, tall. You can tell he's still a baby. And he still got a lot of growing to do. So that means he's still going to be – I'm going to add on some more girth to him. I like his footwork, his redirecting. Like, I feel like – I'm like you, man. Like, I feel like he should be getting looked at more, man. But if you already
– I don't know why his name is not bigger. Like,
he's going to a private school.
Yeah, and I hate that stigma of being in private school to where they don't get the recognition that a lot of these other kids get. But if this man was definitely in a public school at 6'5", edge rusher, scraping down the line like he's doing, he definitely would be on the radar right now for sure. So like I said, I feel like it's our job to bring that attention to these type of kids like this, man. So recruiters, make sure if you're not listening, remember this name, 6'5", 220, Cam Lott from Parkland Academy. Definitely need to be a sought-after recruit for Mississippi. He is the number 96 on our MSA Lit 100 top players in the state of Mississippi in public and private school. Number 96, Camp Lott.
A love letter came through the mail. It said, I miss you. I ripped it up and flushed with the tissue. Try to forget you. I ain't got nothing against you. We human, we all got issues. But I'm tired of being tired. That part of me done died. I see it, then I don't act like I'm blind. I'm confident it won't be one of mine. No emotions come in line. So I tell the truth all the time. Ain't got no sympathy for no.
And welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. We had to pay some bills, had a commercial break, had to pay bills to our sponsors, Major Drip Athletics, and the big name brand. Next
got
up,
to
we
pay
have
the bills.
No, huh?
Say, gotta pay the bills.
Gotta pay the bills. That's all.
Gotta pay the bills. If y'all want this great content to keep coming, we got to pay the bills. And get what we need even more sponsors. So if you interested in being a sponsor, just make sure you email bingomedialLLC@gmail.com. Or MagnoliaAllStarGame@gmail.com, and we'll get you set up with sponsorship packages to be all over all our content that goes for the MSA and Bingo Media platform and major media platform.
All over the state of Mississippi.
And if you know anything like we know, we all over the state of Mississippi. So right back at it, number 95. Now this one right
number
here,
95.
Bingo, this kid right here is a little special, Bingo. They like, oh shoot, they putting freshmen on the top 100 list. Oh my God, they putting freshmen. This kid here is a freshman. This kid, Caden Moss, is 6'5", 275 pounds. He is ranked in 24/7 Sports, not only as the number one player in his class in the state of Mississippi, but the number one player in his class in his position in the country. Do you understand me? The only reason that he's this low is because I want to see more out of him going forward. That's the only reason he this low as a lineman. I want to see more film. He got a lot of film on here, but then he got a lot of like junior high film on here too. You know what I'm saying? So I want to see more. I mean, a lot of JV film, excuse me, junior high and JV film. So I want to make sure that I see more of him going against high school talent. And this year, like I said, so far, I've been hearing good things about him, been seeing good film that he's been posting since the season started. And like I said, he right on schedule, man. Like I said, I see the number one in the country as a freshman last year. What you think, bro?
Man, look, that man is a freshman, man. Look at him running up the field, making look blocks. Look at
this man, bro. Oh, yeah, you know, you're an athlete. He also is a basketball player. He was playing basketball.
He's a baby, man. He's still a baby, but he out there looking like a grown man.
Playing against all type of edge rushers.
Oh yeah, and what school he attend to?
He go to Jackson Academy.
Private school, right?
Yep, private school. Go to Jackson Academy.
Man, see, folks be sleeping on these private schools, but just because your area private schools are not putting out no talent like this, private schools up north, man, they putting out some premier talent.
Okay, let's just keep it a book with the private school thing anyway. Everywhere else but Mississippi, the top players go to private schools. You can look right at all these players that are top players in the country in all these sports, and it's going to say something like Christian behind it, Catholic, Presbyterian. It's going to say something like that behind the school they go to. Ain't nothing Vincent St. Mary. It's going to say something like that. So let's just go and stop the stigma of that. That's why we so left behind. Usually the top ballers in each state go to private schools anyway. I don't know where we get the stigma of he go to a private school, he ain't playing nobody. Bro, if y'all not looked at the private school scene the last 5 years in Mississippi, it's not the same private school scene that you played against in there in 1999, I promise you that.
Man, we know what the case is with that, man. If in the state of Mississippi, if the private schools superseded the public schools, we wouldn't have no Mississippi High School Athletic Association.
No, so that's why I'm glad that kids like this are just popping up out of nowhere. This man is ranked in the country at tackle off of a freshman highlights, off of freshman film. He's ranked off of freshman film.
And so like you said, this footage we're seeing, you could tell this is like some junior high or some.
Yeah, you could like the defensive line. So that's why I didn't rank him as high yet. Just because I want to see him with
more check him out. Screw that. He played D-line too. Look how he's coming up.
That's what I'm saying, going crazy. Like, look at him. This is a big 6'5", 275-pound kid we talking about.
He's a two-way player because he's coming off that ass. Check him out.
Come on now.
This was a freshman footage.
This is all freshman film. Ain't none of this his high school stuff yet.
Going crazy. Yeah, he just had his first probably varsity start yesterday. I mean, Friday.
No, I think like them early highlights on here, they had him playing varsity as a freshman. The early highlights was high school games.
Yeah, he got to begin acting now. ASAP Rocky.
Yes, you already know what type of season he probably having now, because they having a good season right now, Jackson Academy. But like I said, man, y'all make sure y'all remember this kid now. And remember,
we'll see him in December at the top 100.
Off the muscle. We definitely will see him in the super sophomore. He would be the first one getting an invite this year. We'll see you in December, Caden. I promise you, man. But like I said, y'all make sure y'all remember this name I saw Shay posting about it, but just know that we was one of the first people that put him out in this light. To let y'all know that this kid is gonna be that get that deal now. I'm telling you, like off the muscle, he's gonna be that deal. Man, Caden Moss from Jackson Academy, man. Y'all make sure y'all follow that kid. You can move on to the next one, man. It's only one Magnolia.
All right, welcome back. All right, we just went over number 95. Now we have number 94. All right, can you tell us who is number 94 on the top lit 100 of 2004?
Man, number 94 is 2026 wide receiver 6'5", 190 Zayon Cotton from Grenada, Mississippi. I remember Rion speaking about this kid all last year, right when I think the playoffs was going to start, and he made me shift my attention to him. And you know, Josh started putting us on him too after we started talking about him. You know, he's a hometown kid for Josh. But man, let's just roll the tape, man. Let's, like I'm telling this kid, you're 6'5". He has nothing but an upside, first of all. And like I said, the way he splashed on the scene with the stats and everything last year, man, you just know this kid's gonna be one of those guys, man.
Look how big he looks, man. That man looked like a 2-1 receiver already, man.
This man looked like Keenan Allen, man. This man is freaking 6'5", this man is 6'5" right here with nothing but little boys around him, man.
Hey, man, that nigga just ran that for that man. God, look at them. Big body, position receiver. Come across the middle.
Get these folks about me, man.
Why is they got this man out here one-on-one on the island with this man by himself? Hey, ball. I feel it coming
up. Somebody
here.
Over here for some help. I need help. Please.
It is. I knew it.
Please help me over here. This man is 6'5".
He needs some milk.
Already. How big do you think he's going to be in college?
Man, let check my head, ball. Head, ball. Yeah. Give him some milk. Bro. Man, who got the camera, man? This is terrible.
Blur, I'm telling you, like, bro, man, really liked it. They like, man, why did it, bro? Because I already know what this kid's gonna do this year and next year. This kid got two more seasons of this dealing with this man. They got two more seasons of this big 6'5 kid. If y'all thought Caleb Cunningham, then like I said, this splashed on the scene, he come another one. Blur.
I don't know if people starting to pay attention, but Mississippi's starting to become my wide receiver. You now lately, man. Hey, Mike Espen done put some boys out there in the league deep. Now.
Wait till we start getting deep in the countdown, man. We starting to become a lot of you. We rolling quarterbacks out like crazy, and definitely rolling wide receivers out now. Say if you say Mississippi ain't rolling no wide receivers out, you just don't know. You don't know your stuff. I promise you. Who I see. Man, he definitely
he's so big, him. Man. Hey, man, that man look like he about 6'5".
You know, like, you know, when people list people 6'5", you'd be like, is he really 6'5"?
Right, no, nah, he kid, looking on the
nah,
field.
No, this kid is definitely 6'5".
He like, looking.
You ain't even going to have to ask that question. This kid here is something dangerous for one-on-one situation. Oh, my goodness, blurred. Like, what? How do you defend it? I'm lost at how you defend somebody like that. Like, but then, like I said, man, I just wanted to put that spotlight on bro. He's the number 94 top player on our MSA 100s list, man. And like I said, wide receiver 6'5", 190, Zayon Cotton from Grenada. Remember the name, y'all. Screenshot it, tag it, and post it and let him know that he's one of them. I promise you.
Welcome back. Shout out to Major Drip Athletics for that commercial break. We're back right now, and we have up next number 93. Are you ready to reveal who 93 is?
Man, number 93 is 2025 linebacker 6'1", 213, Quincy Butch from Columbus. Look at that man's face. Do he look like he play around on a football field? Let's just keep him up right now. When I think about football player, before we even cut the film on, when I think about football player, I think about this. A dude that looked like he is.
Yeah, look at that man arm. Look at that arm. Look at his arm. Look at his arm, man. Number bang.
He looked like he eats small children. he looked like he sleeps on a bed made out of nothing but cedar blocks. Like he looked like
Hey, I know what you mean, man. Like, hey, bro, he looked like that. He looked like him.
Bro, I know nobody at the school. I know nobody at their school plays with this man on the football field, bro. Like everybody taking all these cute pictures. Now that man, that's a football pitch. That when you think about football player, that's a football pitch right there. Roll the tape. This man is a 3-star. This man's a 3-star now at Columbus. See, this one of them kids that don't get all the hype, but he's a 3-star. He don't get all the hype because he's at a school like Columbus that ain't had no success in a little minute. But now they don't got a new coaching staff and everything. I'm hoping they turn that around. But like I said, this boy here, that man don't even look like he play with him. That man don't even play video games, let alone the radio. How did that?
Check him out.
Roll the tape. What?
Come on. He look like his picture out there when he played. Man, check him out.
I bet he don't wear a visor, gloves, nothing. He probably go straight out there with nothing but his wrist tape. That's it.
Man, put electrical tape around his wrist, man.
He don't even put the regular tape on his wrist, right. Man.
He wasn't no motherfucker. He still out there taping it.
He one of them kids where your mama always got to send him home because he played too rough. He don't say look much. He ain't disrespectful. He look like a yes, ma'am, no, ma'am type of guy. But he looked like a guy that he always was hitting everybody in the neighborhood too hard. And he had to go home. He played too rough. Like, he wanted them kids, like, on everything. Like, this, when you want linebacker, this is what you want. You want to scrape it over the top and come here, everything. Like, ain't none of the stuff like he out there just boom, sticking, throwing his shoulder. Every tackle he making is form tackles.
I'm trying to figure out why Javance Jones ain't went off of this kid, because he his type of linebacker.
Amen. Look, I hope after this video, this boy be having a Jackson State offer if he don't already have one. But I'm pretty sure the 3-star linebacker, 6'1", 219, pretty sure he probably got that.
After the MSA All-Star game, we know what type of linebackers Javance Jones like. He likes
them type of guys.
He likes these type of guys.
You got to slow Javance down. You got to let him know, hold on, remember we don't blitz linebackers in the game. You got to slow him down because he wants them type of guys.
Yeah.
But this kid, man, this kid Quincy Butch, man, from Columbus, bro, this is one of them diamonds in the rough. Like I said, he getting his due diligence by being a 3-star. But like I said, I feel like his name should be on up there some more. But this is going to be a great class of linebackers that you see too. Like Mississippi is just becoming very well-rounded if you want recruits. They are very well-rounded right now with this, man. And like I said, just the video we done played so far, and we ain't even got past the top 10 yet. Just the video we played so far, you wonder who's better than these guys, because these guys are cold. You feel what I'm saying?
Right, man.
This kid here, man, Quincy Butts, he's definitely one of those guys y'all want to remember, bro. He's from Columbus, Mississippi. And like I said, he's a 2025 linebacker, number 93, Quincy Butts.
All right, Quincy, we see you and we hear you.
That man, Quincy Butts, boy. I'm telling you one more time. One more time. Don't move on. Do you hear me? He got me. He looked like he's been a form tackle me right now. Get that man off the screen.
I ain't
hit nobody in years. I do not want to get hit by him. I bet you know how like back in the day we used to play knuckles. Like when you try to hit somebody, get him a frog and they give you one. I bet you nobody ever give him a frog. He probably about knocked your arm off.
that man like nobody mess with him, man. For real. Man,
please don't mess with this kid, man. I'm definitely willing to see more of him, boy. If he don't make the black belt or the Mississippi, Alabama, I know.
We got a spot for him.
I got you a spot right now.
Oh yeah, man. If you don't hear from them other two, come over here. You're gonna be seen, heard, and noticed. I guarantee. Just off this picture, you're gonna walk away with an oath.
I promise we are, but number 93, Quincy Bush from Columbus, man. Y'all make sure y'all remember the name. This is one of those kids that you will see at the next level very soon.
All right. We're back. All right. Now we're into the end of the bottom 10. We're going into number 92. Can you introduce who number 92 is?
Number 92 is a 2025 running back / linebacker, 6'195", Malachi Page from Bay Springs. He just recently committed. I don't know why we got the state picture, because he definitely just committed to Southern, but guess what? Roll the tape. Let's check out this man film. Let me show y'all why he made this top. First of all, the kid is a 3-star. That's first off. You can't go against no kid that's already like ranked like that, especially when they got a resume to go with it. Anytime I see them already ranked, and then they got at least 2 seasons of film on there too for me to go back and refer to, you know you already locked in for something like this from the jump. Feel what I'm saying?
Right.
And that's not political. That's just facts. Like, what do you mean? Like, what? Mm-hmm. You got your film to match your stats and your rankings. Why not? But up to about, if you see this kid, up to about, he would knock you back into Lloyd, Mississippi, what base Freeze said. He would knock you back.
Damn.
The coach had to check and see if he was all right. Man, out that boy, then I'm talking about acting like they made nobody kids now. Like, all right now.
I'm talking about
trying to tackle this big dude. This is a big old.
Hey,
dude.
I'm looking at them, man. Them boys, whoever they green, I can't see what it is they playing.
Look like,
they
look not like they playing Lake or somebody. I know. Well, whoever
that man is not trying to get in front of them tackle. They he is not trying to tackle them, man.
But I'm pretty sure at Southern Miss he's gonna play linebacker because I see like a most of his film was linebacker on film. Even though he did rush for a lot of the yards last year, most of his films. Or a linebacker, and like the man, real life, one of them. And just think about that, bro. We already in just the top 10. How many linebackers we don't have? What, 2-3 in the top 10? Right. Like that's letting you know that we are very well rounded with players in Mississippi that are top guys. Listen, we ranking the top 100 players in the state of Mississippi public and private school, and this kid here, we at 92, and we already don't have 3 linebackers in the top 100.
Right. Well,
so man, like I said, y'all make sure y'all remember this kid name, number 92, 2025 running back linebacker Malachi Page from Bay Springs. Make sure y'all tap in with him. He just committed to Southern Mississippi University.
Good luck, Malachi. I look forward to seeing you this year on the gridiron. If you don't get a call from the mother too, you know who to holler at. We got a spot for you.
It's major. I promise you. It's major now. I promise you now.
All right. All right. Welcome back. Welcome back. All right. We're down to the last two of the final, of the first 10 of the top 100. All right. We're coming in at number 91. Who you have number 91? Can you reveal that there?
Number 91, 2025 O-lineman, 6'7", 295-pound Matthew Parker. From Jackson Prep, roll the tape of this big, massive kid here. I know for a fact he's going to be at somebody's SEC school going crazy at left tackle, and we will be seeing him get drafted one day. 6'7", 295, going to Jackson Prep. You know he don't learn all type of technique with the coaching staff at Jackson Prep. They ain't going to play around with you at the private school with the coaching staff, first of all. Let's just go and know that now. So you know for a fact his technique and everything is going to be on point. Secondly, this man is 6'7", 295 pounds. That's something you cannot teach. You can't teach 6'7", 295, fam. I'm just going to keep it a book with you. And then, like I said, just look how he just throwing around these kids, man. Look, I'm talking about footwork. It's perfect. He hinges the outside like that. It seals the edge. Like, that's crazy. Like, this man, 6'7", moving like this. Look at him on the screen. Crazy out here. Crazy.
Oh, yeah.
I love it, bro. Like I said, that is a big, massive kid, bro. Like I said, the only thing that pushed him this low, being that, I would have wanted to see more film. Like, he don't have this film all the way together. I guess he already got his office together or something like that, but this kid here, I would like to see way more tape on him. That's the only thing that kept him this low, because he's ranked the 3-star on 24/7 Sports. So, like, 247 Sports, however you say it, he's ranked the 3-star on there, so that what brought my attention to him. I saw him at a couple of prep red zone camps. I saw him at a couple of, I think it was the camp that, the Army Bowl camp. Saw him at the Army Bowl camp. And like I said, I just looked at the kid and like, this kid is freaking huge. Why I ain't never heard this kid before? But then I also saw him, I think he trains with like Mike Espy. That was the first time I saw him when I was up in the same facility they was at. He had walked in there. So just that, just to see those type of kids, man, 6'7", 295, there's no way he can't be a top kid in the state of Mississippi. I'm sorry. Number 91,
right.
Matthew
Perkins.
MP. With the Jackson Prep. What goes to Jackson Prep? I said with the Jackson Prep. Goes to Jackson Prep.
All right, shout out to Matthew Parker. All right, we'll be right back to end with the last one. All right, here we are. We done went from 10 to 90. Number 90 is ready to be revealed. All right, give it to us, Big Dog.
Number 90, man, wide receiver, 2025 wide receiver, 6 foot 170, Trey Stevens from Germantown, Mississippi, man. And look here, this was another one of them kids that I promise you I have not heard a lot about until recently. But cut the film on, because I'm wondering why.
Yeah, man. I checked him out in during 707 circuit. His dad, who I know, Travis Stevenson, he put me on him in 707. He played for, I think, Mesh, and I seen him getting busy out there. And I know he just recently, this past week, committed to South Alabama. So
yes, that was brought my attention to him a lot too. I was like, "Damn, that's that kid on the list." I'm like, "Well, look at her," because you know we've been putting this list together for months, y'all. I don't think that it just been something we threw together last week. We've been compiling this list for months because we wanted it to be just right. We didn't want to copy nobody else's list. We want these kids to realize, know that we put emphasis into this. And this kid is going crazy. You see how fast this boy
he left the screen.
You see how he just turned the corner on the board? Oh, my goodness.
Boy, put the burners on, boy. He tied the game up with that one.
Stupid fast. Oh, my goodness.
He tied the game up with that one.
This man is stupid fast. Come here. Come here. Why ain't I heard about this kid, bro? It's crazy. And I've been scouting the whole state for 3 years now for sure. And I'm like, why ain't nobody ever said nothing about Trey Stevens? Well, guess what? We saying something about him now. You better lock in. I know he just committed to South Alabama, but he ain't signed yet, recruiters. So, like I said, it get at his neck, and this man's speed is crazy. Whoop!
Take him out. He got it up.
See, but look at the referee. The referee don't pull something. He got to get everybody out the screen. He getting everybody out the screen. That man is stupid fast, bro. Like I said, I don't know why nobody ain't been talking about Trey Stevenson, but guess what? We talking about Trey Stevens. And I know one thing. I feel like you're going to probably make the Bernard Blackwell, but if you don't,
we got somewhere to be.
And if you need somewhere to go, you see what number you got on. You see what number I got on. You see what number you got on now. That's a fine number now. That's a fine number. You got to get off of that seven. But I love it, though, man. This is a very talented kid, man. We really rolling out nothing but stupid talent all the way through Mississippi. And if you're saying otherwise, you must can't be from Mississippi if you think that we ain't got some of the hottest talent around. So number 90, man, that wraps up our first 10, bro. Our bottom 10 for the top 100 was Trey Stevens from Germantown, Mississippi, wide receiver, 2025 wide receiver. Make sure y'all tap in with him. Make sure y'all remember his name and tune in for part two of the MSA Lit 100 reveal. Got anything to say to him, Bingo?
Yeah, man. shout out to Trey Stevenson for being recognized as one of the top 100 players in the state of Mississippi. You know, there's a lot of lists floating around. And like you said, this list is our list. So you can go make your own. This is ours, and we're doing it.
This list wasn't to go live to be a rebuttal. This list was to celebrate who we feel, since we've been doing this, who is the top 100 kids in the state of Mississippi. Because we don't filter a lot of these kids through the program with the sophomore game the last 2-3 years we've been doing it now. So we know a lot of these kids. So, like I said, that was one of the biggest things, man, was just, like I said, just wanted to put our fingers and toes to work on walking and pointing to the ones that you should be putting your eyes on.
Yeah.
If you're not and, already.
Shout out to our graphics and media guru, Rasu, Snap by Sue. He did all our graphic flyers individually, all 100 for every player.
He did every player.
Right. Had to go find pictures. We're seeing now what school is making sure their players are being seen, heard, and noticed. Because some of these schools, it was hard to find footage,
some
huddle
of them
footage.
They have their school pictures on there. They got 7-on-7 in camp pictures. Yep. Like, they don't even have their school. They don't even have a picture in their school uniforms. And that is very rare in this age.
Right.
But I think we need to do a better job at that. Also, make sure that if y'all tuning in, man, to let us know we finna get ready to drop also the watch list for who we trying to get for our games this year. For the Senior Bowl, the Super Sophomore, and we're introducing the future Elite 8 grade game this year. So like I said, if you got any nomination on there, just click the link that's going to be in the bio where you can nominate the kids. Make sure y'all follow, like, and subscribe to all our platforms, the MSA Network, the major media platform, the Bingo media platform, and make sure you follow us on all social media on Magnolia Sports Association. Man, until next time, we'll be back with the next top 10 to 15. Let's get it.
Make sure y'all like, subscribe, and share all these platforms. Spread the word, you know. It don't cost nothing to share information.
It's only one Magnolia.